Making your way in the world today takes everything you've got. Taking a break from all your worries sure would help a lot. Wouldn't you like to get away? Sometimes you want to go where everybody knows your name, and they're always glad you came. You want to be where you can see our troubles are all the same. You want to be where everybody knows your name. You want to go where people know people are all the same. You want to go where everybody knows your name.
Jackson, didn't they invent Christmas tree lots just so people wouldn't have to drive all the way out in the middle of nowhere and waste a whole Saturday?
They invented them because people forgot how to have an old-fashioned Christmas and are satisfied with scrawny, dead, overpriced trees that have no special meaning.
My toes are numb.
You see, kids, this is what our forefathers did.
I can't feel my leg.
They walked out into the woods, picked out that special tree, and cut it down with their bare hands.
Jackson, I can't feel my hips.
Jackson.
Yes, honey.
Logan's frozen from the waist down.
It's all part of the experience, honey. There it is. The Bare Necessities Christmas tree.
Jackson, don't you think it's a little big?
It's not big, it's just full.
I think it wouldn't even fit in our yard.
It's not going in our yard, Caden. It's going in our classroom. Something else, huh, Logan?
Yeah, it is, Dad. I mean, Jackson.
Isn't it a beaut, Caden?
You'll see it later, bro. His eyes are frozen.
Ah. The most enduring traditions of the season are best enjoyed in the warm embrace of kith and kin. This tui is a symbol of the spirit of the Bare Necessities Christmas.
Did we bring a saw?
I'm back with the senior interview. With me here is Jackson Doring. So Jackson, what's your favorite holiday tradition?
You know, Caden, my favorite holiday tradition is probably opening up presents on Christmas morning.
You know, Jackson, it's a pretty solid choice. So Jackson, what's your favorite holiday food?
My favorite holiday food has probably got to be, as weird as this sounds, eating crawdads at my grandma Doring's.
You just pull them out of the stream and chomp them, or what?
Got that right. Every Christmas morning.
All right. So what are your plans after high school?
Right now I'm enlisted in the Air Guard, so my plans after high school probably go to basic training, then after that go to SCSU. I don't know yet what I'm going to SCSU for, though, so.
Gotta figure it out. Undecided. So, how is the boys' basketball season looking so far? We're a week deep into practice.
That's right. It's been a tough grind so far, but about a week away from our first game, so hopefully we can have a good season, a little consistency this year, and yeah, it's hopefully the seniors can provide some leadership for our team and have a good season.
A little bit of consistency in this inconsistent world, you'd say, huh?
Got that right.
Darn right. This has been a senior moment with Jackson Doring. And we're back with a senior moment. With me here today is Logan Sirk. So Logan, what's your favorite holiday tradition?
Well, my favorite holiday tradition is probably Christmas Eve, because you get all pumped up for the gifts in the next morning.
Yeah, I can barely sleep trying to catch Santa, you know?
Yeah.
So, what's your favorite holiday food, if you can even have food?
Oh, well, Christmas is my favorite holiday because I can eat whatever I want for a couple of days anyways. Thanksgiving, awful, even though that's the main food holiday. But no, Christmas is the real food holiday for me, so pretty much anything I'll eat.
Anything for Logan. So, what are your plans after high school?
I'm going to go probably into elementary education. Where I'm going to go is I'm pretty undecided about that. And, yeah, that's pretty much it.
Wowza. So, how is this wrestling season going to look?
Well, we've had two competitions so far this week, two duels. The team's wrestled pretty well. There's a few younger kids on the team that have been learning pretty quick, but we have a few top dogs, I guess you could say, including Peyton Frederick. He's from Beersford. He's wrestling pretty well. And after Jovi gets back from his injury, hopefully he starts wrestling well too.
Would you say that you are wrestling well?
I'd say I'm wrestling decent, that's for sure.
Decent, he says. All right, this has been a senior moment with Logan Sirk. Green.
Hello, ladies and gents. Today on Senior Interview, we're reversing the roles a little bit and interviewing Caden. So, Caden, my first question that I'm going to extend to you is, during the Christmas holiday, how much insulin do you think you take?
Well, Christmas is a pretty big hitter for food, you know. You know, I'm taking probably 20 for a meal for Christmas. Man, I spilled all over myself, too.
I can see that. So, Logan, you have a question for Caden here?
Yeah. So, as you can see, our friend is low right now. That is why he's eating. Caden, what are your numbers right now?
58.
That is not very good if you didn't know. Jackson?
So, Caden, what's your outlook on this year's basketball season with, as you stated earlier, a week of practices under your belt? So.
Well, yeah, practice has been going good. We got a new guy, Rodrigo. He's huge.
Of course.
Y'all better watch out if you're from a different school. I think we're going to do pretty well. We got five seniors who've all played together for a long time, and the juniors are going to step up. So.
I see. Here we go, Logan.
All right, Caden, this is a hard question for you, kind of. But what is the best Christmas gift you have ever received on Christmas morning?
When I was three, I got this fake watch. That was like the light of my life for probably a year. So.
Nice. Yeah. Nice. Yeah.
Did you know it was fake?
No. It was a sticker. It was a watch, a plastic watch with a sticker on it that read like 3:30 or something. I thought it was real.
So it was always 3:30.
It was always 3:30 in my mind. Yeah. A 3:30 state of mind.
It's always 3:30 in Margaritaville.
Yeah.
All right. This has been a senior moment with Caden Glennans. Merry Christmas, folks. And today we have for you another episode of Secret Smorgasbord. So I was told this is a Christmas edition. Am I right, Caden?
Sort of. We got a few Christmas foods, but most of them are just horrible.
Delicioso. Let's get it started.
All right, let's go. Here, this first food, I'll be feeding you a spoonful.
Oh, yes, please. Oh, that's a lot.
It's huge. Ready?
Always ready.
You can clasp your mouth around. It is powder, so don't breathe.
Ugh.
Taste.
Ugh.
Taste it. Where's the garbage at?
It's always garbage? The first one. You always right. Always puked every time.
Nope. I'll follow it.
You spray it like snow.
Fuck out.
It's right below you. Yes?
What is that, taco seasoning?
Nope.
Ugh, it's terrible. You put so much in my mouth.
Yeah.
It's Parmesan cheese, folks. Parmesan cheese.
Ugh.
That smells bad.
Alright, you ready for this next one? Well, you put a heaping load in my mouth.
Here.
I'm watching you.
Here. You can't watch me.
This is a fork putter in your mouth.
Don't touch it.
Hey, no touching.
That's slimy. That's the
You're missing your mouth. You're missing your mouth.
There you go.
It's not bad. It's not bad. What's your taste?
It's like a peach or something like that.
Mm-hmm.
All right. Halved peach.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, you got one question.
Merry Christmas.
That was pretty good.
Merry Christmas.
This next one you might not guess, but it might not be also, might not be that bad.
So, same thing, fork down.
Fork right here, and downer.
It's a weird texture.
It's a weird food.
That's for sure.
That's not good. I have no clue what that is. That wasn't very good.
Zucchini and Italian pasta sauce. It smells bad, but
tastes bad. Jingle bells, Why is that a Christmas with Miss Mac?
No.
This is kind
of
Christmas.
This is sort of Christmas. Okay? So, this food I've been told by your family you don't like. Some of you at home might like this
food. You betrayed me, seriously. My whole family betrayed me.
Some of you at home might like this food.
So is this like a shout out to Shania?
No, this isn't. This is a, I'm disappointed in you, Shania.
This is a shout out to Gabe King.
Ooh.
Because he gave me this idea.
Hey,
no sniffing. Just eat it. I'm hoping he throws up on this. Maybe
only a little bit. Oh, it's a mushroom. No, olive? That's not good.
All right, this next one is a drink.
Okay. How about we give me a second?
Okay. You don't like olives that much? Not that bad.
At all.
Not that bad.
All right.
Olives are terrible.
To wash this down, we got
this one. You might actually like
a Christmas drink.
We're not sure.
And your goal here is to finish the whole drink.
Drink it.
The whole drink. What do I get if I finish the whole drink?
Nothing.
People laugh. Don't sniff it. Just drink it.
I can do what I want.
Sniff it. Just drink it. Oh, he likes it, maybe. I, for one, like it. You never have?
Was it good?
It's eggnog. Not alcoholic, of course.
Oh, of course. We keep it clean.
Yes, of course. But it's good, nonetheless.
Man.
What'd you say?
No. I prefer water.
All right, now on to the food.
This was
would make me vomit if I had to eat it.
This was made by Caden.
This was made by me. I picked this out. If you guys can see in there.
There's just a... mosh pit.
I made a sandwich of these ingredients.
Yeah. Well, let's mention to the audience, you've destroyed my digestive system.
Oh, yeah. He can't even eat hot Cheetos anymore.
Terrible.
He gets gut pain.
It's so bad. Okay, where's the food here?
It's a sandwich. Just throw her back. Just eat the sandwich. Don't take the sandwich apart. Stop.
How can you ruin a sandwich?
Stop.
You ruined
You're
somehow.
Flapping it around.
You've ruined this sandwich somehow.
Just eat it.
There's a weird meat right in the middle.
What's in the middle?
A weird what?
It's not a meat. I swear it's not a meat.
A weird meat.
Chew it. Yes.
I think that's cheese on the outside. That's
yep,
normal.
It is.
That's normal. There's
Kraft,
something.
It's a Kraft single, bent in half.
There's something in the middle. I don't know what it is, but it's throwing off the entire flavor of this, and I'm kind of peeved right
yes.
now.
Would you like to try the middle thing alone? Would you like to try a piece of the middle thing by itself?
Oh! It's starting to like open up in my mouth. That is just, yeah. That is tangy right now, man.
Would you like to try a little bit of the middle?
I don't know if I want to.
Do it for the fans. Yeah. Do it for the fans. Come on.
And it's thrown away.
So you can get away? That cost like $5.
Ugh. It was like chalky.
Yeah, well, what is it? What does it taste like?
I don't know.
So you mixed it with a big bowl of mayo. What would it? Or sour cream.
What?
It's a mix.
Mix of what?
It's like a dip.
It's like a dip you find at a party or a gathering. It's ranch powder.
You put ranch powder?
It's a ranch powder cheese sandwich.
So you took a slice of cheese.
Fold it in half.
Thought, let's put some cheese.
Okay.
Let's put some ranch powder on that.
Originally,
Jackson really liked
originally,
that.
I mixed the ranch powder in a glass of water and heated it up. So you would have had to drink that. And she saved you from that because I wanted to do it.
Like, on what planet does that sound like a good idea?
It's not a good idea. That's why I gave it to you.
And that's the whole premise of this show. It's not
really
a good idea, but let's
kill
feed
Jackson's
it to Jackson.
Intestines.
Okay, what's next?
That was the last food.
That was it.
So. You made it.
I ender, made it, huh?
Ender off.
You want some more eggnog for the
no,
UMO?
No. Disgusting. 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 Disgusting.
Delicious.
Pretty good. I'll have another one of those.
Yes, sir. I ate two of them.
Crunch.
Yummo!
And on the next segment, there'll be a QR code. Scan that and submit your crazy food ideas
please
for us.